Hi, everybody. It's Leslie with the planetary changes for March. There's so many changes coming this month, next month, and the next month. I'll have that. I'll put a little video on for you so you know. Well, one of the big changes is Pluto, which stays in your house 28 years. Some books say 28, some say 23, but it's a long time. It's going into Aquarius, and this means new projects, new things. Getting rid of the old, letting go of old things, change new things, bringing in a lot of new things that you've thought about or maybe didn't ever think you'd change something, and you will. It's sometimes changing partners or friends. It's doing a lot of volunteer work, if you like, or something, helping someone very much. That'll be March to June, it will be like that. And then Venus goes into Uranus, and the moon is in Taurus, so that's in this month. I don't have the dates for that with you. But that will make you feel like you really want to go with the flow. Sunday meeting sextile will meet Mars, and that's the meeting of Mars and it's very important. It's very, very important because Mars gives us a lot of our energy and to do things. So it's going to Mercury's going to sextile Mars, which is your communication and your energy. So you'll be more talky than you normally are. And 23 years, Pluto is going to be in Aquarius. More, by the way. And that's a big one. And it does mean the finish of things, the starting of new things, very much so. It's big. It's a big, big change. Capricorn will be in the 7th house in Aquarius after the 13th of June. Pluto will stay there too. It will change the 2024, these changes will happen, the Capricorn also. Into Pluto. Although the Capricorn, Aquarius, and Capricorn and Aquarius in Aquarius will go until June. Okay. And Saturn is in Aries. Actually, Saturn is going to go into Capricorn. It's going to be very good for Capricorn, which sometimes we feel like Saturn is such a downer because it really is the one that shows us what we need to do, brings up things when we're wrong, when sometimes nothing can go right for a couple of years, and that's really true. Although we all believe in the Lord can change all this since He made the planets and He made all the things that are happening here, but we have to make sure that we know and we ask for help with it. And it will bring, for Capricorns, it will bring them to a higher level. And Aries is going to be going to a much higher level, much big change, a good wanted change. You may not want it to start with, but you'll find it's very good for you, and you'll be much happier, much freer. Aries, things will be able to let go, because even though, let's say Pluto's going into Pisces, it's going into Pisces. It doesn't mean that it always goes into some house of another planet. But it can be not significant, not even that you notice, okay? And you have to really manifest at a higher level because that will affect everyone just a little bit, but it really will be in Pisces. And 326 Mars into Cancer for 6 weeks, 326 for 6 weeks on, and 1023, Mars in Cancer will go retrograde. Also, and help you be moving forward, letting things go. That's what that will be doing for you. And here, if I can get this apart, it's very, very, very important. These changes are important, and especially the Pluto, the Saturn, very important. But a lot of things follow the Uranus. Uranus is a planet making things happen, new things happen, and so. Look forward to where Uranus is if you read that when you're reading horoscopes, if it says that, you know, it's good things will be coming. And but it can be good or it's faster, fast changes, and something could happen today that you never expected, and it could be good, or something you have to change and do something with. And just to let you know, the new moon is the 21st, and that also is the spring equinox, which is very, very nice. New moons are usually very, very nice. The full moon is on the 7th, and it's in, it depends on what house it is for you. So it will be in Virgo also this year, or this month. So anyway, have a good month. I hope you enjoyed that little bit of information. I'm sorry I was stuttering there, but have a wonderful month, and we have some more videos for you next week. Bye-bye.